Welcome to Appuals, your go-to place for tech fixes, troubleshooting, and optimization guides. Hello everyone, it's Eamon from Appuals.com. Let's dive into today's main topic. If your PC is running slow, the fan is making noise, or you notice high CPU usage in Task Manager, the WMI Provider Host might be the culprit. The WMI Provider Host is part of Windows Management Instrumentation, WMI, and helps with system monitoring. However, sometimes it misbehaves, causing excessive CPU usage and leading to system lag and overheating. Without wasting any more time, let's get straight into the methods to fix the WMI provider, host high CPU usage, and get your system back to normal. Method 1. Restart the Windows Management Instrumentation service. Press the Windows key plus R to open the Run command dialog. Type services.msc into the dialog and press Enter. In the Services window, scroll down or use the Find function by clicking any service and pressing the W key to quickly locate the Windows Management Instrumentation WMI service. Right-click on the Windows Management Instrumentation service and select Restart if restarting the service does not resolve the issue. We will move on to the next method, which includes restarting all the dependency services. To simplify this process, we have provided batch commands for you that you can access from our detailed webpage about this error. Check our description for the direct link to the article below. Basically, this batch file automatically restarts all the services for you. Go to the link mentioned in the description down below, go ahead, click on it, and it will redirect you on the Appuals website. Now select all commands, right-click on the commands, and select copy. Now open Notepad, paste all these commands, now click on File, then click on Save As, choose the destination, type any name with .bat extension, and Save As Type, choose All Files. Then click on Save. Right-click on the batch file, the .bat file you just created, and select Run as Administrator. Once you click Run as Administrator, the batch file will execute the commands automatically and close on its own. These commands stop and restart the IP Helper, Windows Security Center, and Windows Management Instrumentation Services in an attempt to resolve high CPU usage by resetting them. By the way, if you're the kind of user who prefers detailed guidance, we highly recommend following all the steps through our article. These articles are written step by step, complete with screenshots, to ensure you don't miss anything. Alright, let's get back to the tutorial. Anyway, once that's done, restart your PC and check if the CPU usage is back to normal. If not, let's move on to the next fix. Methods 2. Another possibility is that a third-party application is causing the issue. To check this, we'll perform a clean boot. A clean boot starts Windows with a minimal set of drivers and startup programs, which helps us identify if a background program is interfering with WMI Provider Host and causing the high CPU usage. To do this, press Windows key plus R to open the Run dialog box. Type msconfig and press Enter. Click on the Services tab. Check the box that says Hide All Microsoft Services. This is important because it prevents you from accidentally disabling essential Windows services. Click the Disable All button. This will disable all non-Microsoft services. Click Apply. Now click on the Startup tab and click on the Open Task Manager option. In the Task Manager's Startup tab, you'll see a list of programs that start automatically when Windows boots. For each application that is enabled next to it, click on the application and then click the Disable button. Restart the computer. Once restarted, start enabling services and startup items one by one. To pinpoint the culprit, follow these steps. First, open system configuration again by pressing their Windows plus R key together. Then type msconfig and hit Enter. Go to the Services tab and check Hide All Microsoft Services to display only third-party services. Now enable service one by one, re-enable each service one at a time, monitoring CPU usage after each, and if enabling a service spikes CPU usage, uninstall the related program via Control Panel. If no issue is found in service, repeat the process with startup programs in Task Manager Startup Programs. Methods 3. If the issue is still present, let's use the Event Viewer to find the process causing the problem. If you're not familiar with Event Viewer, don't worry, I'll guide you through it. It's a built-in Windows tool that shows detailed information about important events on your computer. Think of it like a logbook for your PC. Event Viewer records things like system errors, application crashes, security events, and other important system activities. It's a valuable tool for troubleshooting because it helps you see what's happening behind the scenes. It lets you check logs related to different parts of your system, hardware, services, applications, and provides information about whether they're working correctly or if there are any problems. It essentially acts as a combined system log, giving you insights that can help diagnose and fix issues. Press Windows key plus X and select Event Viewer from the menu, or press the Windows key and type Event Viewer in the search bar, then click on it. In the Event Viewer window, look at the top toolbar and click on View. Make sure there's a check mark next to Show Analytic and Debug Logs. If there isn't, click on it to enable them. This is important because it makes more detailed logs visible. In the left-hand pane, the navigation tree, expand the following folders in this order: Applications and Services Logs, Microsoft, Windows, WMI Activity. Finally, click on Operational under WMI Activity. This is where the relevant logs are stored. Look for errors, and when you find one, check the General tab for Client Process ID. Take note of the number next to it. Next, open Task Manager by pressing the Windows plus R keys together, typing Task MGR, and hitting Enter. Then, go to the Services tab and find the service with the matching process ID. Once located, disable it by right-click, go into Detail. These services either related to programs or Windows related. If it's program related, then uninstall it. Afterward, head over to Control Panel, locate Programs and Features, and click on it. Now uninstall the associated program. But if it's Windows related, you can simply restart it and see if that can resolve the problem or not. If nothing else has worked so far, you can set the WMI service to start only when needed. Open Command Prompt as administrator by clicking on the Windows icon, typing CMD, right-clicking on it, and selecting Run as administrator. In the Command Prompt window, type sconfig WMI start equals demand, press Enter, and restart your PC. Hopefully, this will resolve the issue. Let us know if this works for you. All right, folks, that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully, one of these fixes worked for you. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to Appuals for more Windows-related fixes and troubleshooting guides. For a detailed guide with screenshots, check out our website, Appuals.com. Many of our topics are inspired by your suggestions, so your input really matters. See you in the next one. Take care. Bye.